Hey everyone, welcome to my podcast. My name is Kelly Fong. I am a year 10 student at Binus School Serpong. Today's topic is a crime mystery. It is a cold case that has never been solved. It's about a stalker dubbed The Watcher that lives in the suburbs of Westfield, New Jersey. He is the latest of a generation of men who have terrorized and stalked a specific house on 657 Boulevard for decades. The thing that makes this case haunting, in my opinion, is the fact that it happened in 2014, meaning that the stalker may still be around, creeping around unsuspecting families, friends, and children. Over a series of months, the Watcher terrorized his victims with letters hinting and threatening to harm the victims. He included their private details in the letters, nudging the fact that the Watcher was someone the victims knew or had been around. We are going to be examining the first piece of evidence in this case, which is the letter written and signed by The Watcher. At the time, the inhabitants of 657 Boulevard were the Broaddus family, Derek and Maria Broaddus and their three children. They had recently acquired the 6-bedroom home and were doing renovations before they moved in June. Seeing that it was a previously vacant house, there wasn't much in the mail except for a single white envelope. It was addressed to, quote-unquote, the new owner. The first line goes, "Dearest new neighbor at 657 Boulevard, allow me to welcome you to the neighborhood." Now, I believe this greatly hints at the fact that the Watcher lives in the neighborhood around the Broaddus' new home. That's terrifying. Imagine having a psychopath living near you and your family. It's like in one of those horror movies where the character is looking out the window and suddenly the monster appears in front of them, scaring them half to death. The difference here is that this is reality. It's entirely possible. It's entirely possible for you to be standing on the porch of 657 Boulevard and a man comes and does horrible things to you. Now, these things wouldn't come to mind when you read those first two sentences. It sounds exactly like a regular housewarming from, say, a possibly shy neighbor. The rest of the letter would imply otherwise. How did you end up here? Did 657 Boulevard call to you with its force within? 657 Boulevard has been the subject of my family for decades now, and as it approaches its 110th birthday, I have been put in charge of watching and waiting for its second coming. My grandfather watched the house in the 1920s, and my father watched in the 1960s. It is now my time. Do you know the history of the house? Do you know what lies within the walls of 657 Boulevard? Why are you here? I will find out. See, the thing that interests me in this excerpt is that it hints at a family that believes something otherworldly resides in 657 Boulevard. A family with a cult following to the house, even resorting to watching it and passing that responsibility to their offspring. It hints at the Watcher having aggression to anyone who disturbs the house, in this case by living in it. Sort of this superiority complex where the Watcher claims to know all about the house and feels as if he is entitled to quote-unquote protect the house. The following excerpt continues my belief that the Watcher is a psychopath. I see already that you have flooded 657 Boulevard with contractors so that you can destroy the house as it was supposed to be. Bad move. You don't want to make 657 Boulevard unhappy. See what I mean? He's making 657 Boulevard to be this malevolent entity, all stemming from his delusions of a second coming. It's, I feel, a bit psychotic. Whether or not he believes this to be true, or if he's doing this to strike fear into the Broaddus' hearts, to drive them away or something, the only thought in my mind is, why would you do that? What horrible person or what horrible event must have shaped you for you to be so spiteful, for you to want a family who does not know who you are, to live in constant fear? This type of thing can cause what, PTSD or paranoia? The Watchers know that the Broadduses have children, as proved by this next excerpt. You have children. I have seen them. So far, I think there are 3 that I have counted. Are there more on the way? He has seen them. He knows they exist. And imagine for a second, Imagine the Broaddus' children find these letters. They are children and their minds will run wild, and as a result, they may develop PTSD and or paranoia. And it will hinder their development. It might damage them in an irreversible way, in a way that I suspect the Watcher was damaged himself. I believe that the Watcher, as a child, was told stories of 657 Boulevard by his father and his grandfather. He was fed stories of 657 Boulevard since he was a child, and since young children's minds are pliable, this caused him to develop into this psychopath with a focus on 657 Boulevard, who has this sort of possessive need to keep the house within their family, even if it does not legally belong to them. Linking back to my previous statements, he is waiting for this quote-unquote second coming that his family believes will come from the house, inducing the sort of mindset where the house was this entity to be revered, that it could deliver this spiritual awakening of sorts. Another excerpt shows just how insane the Watcher is. "Do you need to fill the house with the young blood I requested? Better for me. Was your old house too small for the growing family, or was it greed to bring me your children? Once I know their names, I will call to them and draw them to me." The terror you must feel as a parent to have your child threatened to be abducted, maybe by someone you know, maybe from one of the gardeners that walk past, or maybe the ice cream truck that drives by. You get what I'm trying to say, it's horrifying. There's this instinct, at least I've heard, to protect your child at all costs when danger threatens them. The Watcher is so psychopathic that he's referring to the children as young blood, and also implying that it will be the parents' fault for what might happen to their children due to their greed. Naturally, hearing this, you might want to teach your children to stay away from strangers and to never walk alone. However, the final paragraph is the most terror-inducing one, I feel. "Who am I? There are hundreds and hundreds of cars that drive by 657 Boulevard each day. Maybe I am in one. Look at all the windows you can see from 657 Boulevard. Maybe I am in one. Look out at any of the many windows in 657 Boulevard at all the people who stroll by each day. Maybe I am one." The Watcher brings up a valid point. He could be anyone, anywhere, at any time. And this is truly what terrifies me. The possibility that you don't truly know anyone, that they always have a hidden motive, because it's impossible for someone to know another completely, isn't it? There are so many cases where the victim knew their assailant. Your neighbor could be a merry murderess, your best friend might be a psychopath, or your own brother could be planning your own murder. The letter I have read today is only one of many the Watcher has sent to the Broaddus' family, and to cover them all in detail would take me much more than 8 minutes. Therefore, this brings me to my conclusion, which is the pinnacle of this dissection. I believe that the Watcher is still out there. I believe he is watching and waiting for his second coming, and that his entire existence centers on 657 Boulevard. He is just another one of the crazy stalkers that haunt our world. We have to keep each other safe and look out for one another. After all, you never know who's watching.